I'm just gonna say this before we get started with this video today. There was someone who commented on one of my videos a couple weeks ago when I was wearing a hat inside. They were saying, "Why are you wearing a hat inside?" And I'm a grown man. If I want to wear a hat in my own home, I will. But there's also another reason. I don't think there's any of us who really want to watch this for a whole video. I know when I'm editing this video later, I wouldn't want to stare at this either. So, yeah, if you ever see a hat, it's probably a bad hair day. Hey, what's up? I'm Rafael D. Furia, aka Rafi D is me, and I am back at it again on another beautiful Friday night. And this week I wanted to do something a little bit different. Sometimes there are questions that I get under the comment sections of my videos that I would love to answer, but unfortunately I don't feel as though maybe there's enough content for a full video. So what I want to try in this video today, and maybe I'll do it in the future if you guys are liking this sort of thing, where I do some rapid fire questions and answering questions that you guys have left on videos or that I've received by email. But before we get too much deeper into the video, if you would like to see more content like this about moving to Italy, Italian dual citizenship, and living life abroad, please be sure to subscribe with that notification bell turned on. And if you could also give this video a like, I'd really appreciate it, as it does help out the channel. But if you would like to help out the channel in another way, and to help make more videos like this possible on a monthly basis, you can go to rafaeldfuria.com/patreon. Or if you'd like to help out just once, you can go to rafaeldfuria.com/support. Also, a huge thank you to those of you who watched last week's video and left feedback. I really, really do appreciate all of the feedback you guys gave me. I've been trying to think about how I want to keep going forward with this channel and how I can keep it interesting for you guys. So that really gave me a lot of fantastic information last time. So thank you really so much. I'm sorry that I haven't been able to answer everybody's comments, but please know that I have read through all of them and they all make a huge difference. Thank you. So the first comment from today's video was actually left on last week's video from Miguel Santos. Hey Rafael, I wanted to ask you, I need my glasses for this. I can like kind of make out some of the words. Hey Rafael, I wanted to ask you, how do you look for a girlfriend in Italy? Like, what places do you go to? I'm the wrong guy to ask. I have no clue about these things. I'm not the type of guy that just goes and hits on girls in the club. I'm not the type of guy that even really goes to the club. But I'm an old-fashioned guy that's looking for an old-fashioned girl, but I can't say that I'm actively looking. And if I meet someone, then that's great, but I'm not actively looking. I would say, though, how do you do it where you are? Like, basically, humans are human. I've said this before in videos. I would say do it the same way that you do it in your country, but maybe going out for aperitivi. That could be a thing. I would guess it also depends on what kind of girl you're looking for. If you enjoy doing sports, then maybe go join a gym and take a class. Or if you enjoy being more artsy, then take an art class. Or if you enjoy going out and getting wasted, then go out, get wasted. This next comment was also left on last week's video. Rafael, what the fudge are you still doing in beautiful, but alas expensive northern Italy? Move south. Wonderful and most economical places are to be found in La Marche and Abruzzo. Mountains and sea, what else do you want from life? I'll tell you that in a minute. It gets even better further south, Molise, Puglia, or super beautiful Sicily. Good luck. Ciao, bello. So what more could I want from life? That would be to make a living. I don't mean to talk badly about the South, but as somebody who is in their late 20s and restarting their life, and I don't have a pension coming from anywhere, I don't have any sort of passive income. If I were retiring, this would be a different sort of story. Then I would say, okay, the South might be a better place. But for somebody who's needing to work, the South, from a practical perspective, would not be the right choice for me. If I were looking for just the bella vita, the dolce vita, or the pizza, pasta, and amore, of course, shirts, mugs, baby onesies, and more can be found in the link down in the more info section below. But if I were just looking for that pizza, pasta, and amore, I don't think I would be able to get by. I don't think, when I've looked for jobs in the South before, you get paid significantly less, even though the cost of living is significantly less. I would say it leaves less wiggle room. If I could earn basically the same type of living in the North as I could in the South, then I would think maybe about that. But also the other factor is I hate the heat. I really hate it. Okay, I moved to the wrong country. If we're talking about heat and humidity, at this point in my life, I can't imagine that the South would be the right choice for me. And even when I was in Palermo, I was talking to a woman that was working at the hotel there, and she said she had been working at different jobs. She finally got this job at this hotel that I was staying at, and that most places there pay horribly. She was working in one place where it was like a nail salon, and she was getting paid something like 250 euros per month, working 6 days a week, and I think it was like 10 hours a day, something absolutely completely ridiculous for that many hours. And that falls into line with what I've seen for even English teaching. I was looking at an English teaching job in some small village not too far from Naples a while back, and they were offering like less than a third of what someone would earn here in Alto Adige. Yes, of course, the cost of living there is less, but then when it comes to like cost of food and going to the supermarket and stuff like that, the costs aren't so different from north to south that I've seen. At least when I was down in Sicily, the supermarkets there, like when I went to Lidl, were very close to what they would be here. Actually, there was a few things that I saw that were more expensive than they were here, but that is also probably because of transportation to Sicily, because it's an island. But cost of living was for sure something that I took into account when choosing my next place that I'm going to be moving to. But that's something I'm going to be talking about in an upcoming video, and I'm thinking maybe sometime in the near future, I might do a video about what I look for before moving abroad, because that's something that I've been asked about. What do I look for when moving abroad or in moving in Italy? Like, what are the factors that I personally look into? The next question on, I think actually the same video, Nani C. Hello, we are currently in Northern Italy looking to live here. Did you use different websites to find your new place, or did you go directly through an agency? So actually for my next place that I'm moving into, it was kind of, like I said, by knowing a guy who knows a guy. So that's what I was talking about a little bit in my last video, is a lot of things that happen in Italy can go a little bit more smoothly if you know a guy who knows a guy. It's just kind of how it works a little bit sometimes. But actually for this apartment, well, it kind of happened in a similar way. But this one, I did go through an agency, but it was, and I would recommend for anybody who doesn't speak Italian well, or they're very new to Italy, which if you're new to Italy, you would probably also not be speaking Italian so well. Just anyway, in general, like the first time you rent an apartment or the first couple times, if you really don't understand the situation here, and if you really don't understand the system, very worthwhile to have someone on your side who can help explain things to you, especially if you're an English speaker, to find someone who is an English speaker. That's going to be a lot more difficult, but possible. And to have somebody there who can explain to you maybe some of the differences between the system where you're from and the system that exists here, because there are a lot of things that are very, very different about how things work here, about how much time you have to give for notice, who pays the taxes and who pays the this, who pays the that. It goes into a lot of details that wouldn't necessarily be thought about in the States. Like, I remember in the States, the long-term contract was considered 2 years. And even I remember one time when I was a kid, my mother asked if it would be possible to get a contract for longer than 2 years. And they looked at her, I was like, what the hell's wrong with you? Like, why would you want to stay here for more than 2 years? Why would you want to sign a contract? But here in Italy, 3+2 or 4+4. There's one more term that's also kind of normal, but those are the two most common that I've heard of. And when I'm talking about 3+2, 4+4, I'm talking about 3+2 years or 4+4 years. At the point after 3 years, you have a way that you can legally get out of the contract, but then also after 4 years in the 4+4, you also have a legal out. But generally also as a tenant, you do have a legal out if you can give them X amount months of notice. And on to the next one. Actually, I think this was also left on the same video. I was trying to pick off of different videos here, but I think this is all the same video. Are there English-based schools in Italy? This was left by Kang Mekma. I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing that. But I would say that it depends on what age level we're talking about. If we're talking about elementary school, there are American schools that exist in the country. I think Milan has, and I think Rome has. I don't know if there are any others, but then if you're talking about more university level, I wouldn't say that there are any necessarily English-speaking universities. There very well could be, but I've never studied in Italy, so I may be the wrong person to ask about this also. But I know for sure that there are some universities that do have programs in English. Like, for example, not far from where I currently live in Bolzano, they do offer programs in English, but it's necessary to have some German under your belt and Italian. And when I say some under your belt, I mean actually quite a bit. Some courses require B1 or B2, but then there are some courses that do require a C1, if I'm not mistaken. Or I think Bocconi in Milan offers programs in English, but I think you also still have to know some Italian. And then I think there are film schools in Bologna and Florence where you can study in English. I know there is a summer program in Florence for film school that is supposed to all be in English, but I don't know the age range. I would assume it's either teenage, like high school years, or it could be like a summer abroad, or it could be like a summer abroad university program. I'm not sure quite which. And on to the next one. On, I don't know which video this was left on, from Tarek Ben. Have you ever been in Bologna? So I'm going to go with the technicality of how that was phrased. Been in Bologna? Yes. You can check out my video from not too long ago. I'll try to remember to put a card up in one of the corners. I think it's this corner here, for when I was traveling by train and I was going to near Bologna. But the most that I've seen of Bologna is just the train station, and basically just across the street from the train station, there was one place across from there where it looked like they had a lot of deep fried Sicilian goodies. So the next time I'm in Bologna, I have to go there. But I have not been around Bologna. Like, for example, I've technically been in Rome, but I've never been around Rome. Or like, I've been to Verona, but I've never really been around Verona. Like, I've been to the train station and the airport. So I can say technically I've been in these cities, but have I been around? No. Anyway, there are plenty more questions that I would love to answer, but I don't think I have enough time to do that in this video, so I'm going to leave that off for another video. If you guys are liking this type of video where I answer a few questions in one video, let me know down in the comment section below. Or if you have any questions, feel free to leave them down there, and maybe it might become a topic for a future video, or maybe it might make it into one of these videos. And of course, if you'd like to see more content like this about moving to Italy, Italian dual citizenship, and living life abroad, please be sure to subscribe with that notification bell turned on, and if you could also give this video a like, I'd really appreciate it, as it does help out the channel. And also, if you'd like to help out the channel in another way and would like to help make more videos like this possible, you can go to rafaeldifuria.com/patreon to help on a monthly basis. Or if you'd like to help out just once, you can go to rafaeldifuria.com/support. And of course, as always, I'm Rafael Di Furia, aka Rafi D is me, and thank you so much for joining me on another beautiful Friday night. I hope you all have a fantastic weekend, and I look forward to seeing you all next Friday. Later.